My name is Alin Belzel. I'm the boathouse manager at the Calgary Rowing Club, and we're proud members of Sport Calgary.
One simple question.
Yeah.
What is the sport of rowing?
So rowing, it's actually kind of unique in the fact that you're moving backwards while you row. So you have a small little shell. It's maybe 30 to 40 inches in width. And then you use a sliding seat to use your oars to move backwards throughout the water. And the whole point of rowing is you want to go as fast as possible. It's a full body sport. Biggest muscle is your legs. And then you use your body and your arms to finish off the stroke. And then you row down a 2,000 meter course. Any standard race would be 2,000 meters. It kind of depends on where you row, but that's our standard distance.
There are different boat classes and different types of rowing techniques. Can you touch on a little bit about those? I know that there's two major ones.
Yeah, so there's two major differences in rowing. So there's sculling. You have a smaller oar, you have one oar in each hand, and so it's a little bit more even on the body. And then you have sweeping, and what sweeping is you have two hands on one oar, and you swing out to either the right side or the left side, or port or starboard. Sculling, you can be in a boat by yourself, which we call a single, because you have an oar on either side of you, so you'll go in a straight line. You can't be in a boat by yourself with sweeping. You only have one oar, so you need another person in the boat with you. You can either be in a single, a double, or a quad when you're sculling, or in a pair, a four, and an eight when you're sweeping.
There is a very special position out there that actually doesn't hold an oar at all.
Oh yeah, the best position of all, in my opinion.
Yeah.
So it's called a cox, or a coxswain. Basically what they do is they steer the boat, and they yell out directions to the crew. Different from popular opinion, they don't just yell row, row, row. This would be an eight, and then you can see Ben there has a little microphone on that he's the coxswain of the eight.
That's cool. It's almost like you have a coach in the boat.
Yeah, it honestly is, yeah, for sure. They're definitely as much a part of the crew as any of the rowers are. They make just as big of a difference. Part of the misconception, I believe, comes from the fact that you're sitting down. So a lot of people don't realize that your seat moves, or that, you know, like you are heading backwards, and it's a lot more powerful to push away than to pull. And a lot of people think, you know, rowing, like I'm rowing my little dinghy as I fish. So I think that's kind of where the misconception comes from. But it's a lot more intense than that, which is kind of awesome. We want people to see how it's actually a sport, and it's blooming in Canada to be a more popular sport than what people conceive it as. It's really inclusive as a sport. You know, we have people 80 years old rowing, we have people 11 years old rowing, we have people in wheelchairs rowing, and we have Olympic athletes that have come out of the Calgary Rowing Club, right? So it really is a club for everyone. We don't want any kids who are too small. We don't want to wreck their backs. It's a sport where you are taking a lot of load with the water, and so you need to be not so much a weight, more like a general size. Our oldest member of the club, he's over 80 years old.
Wow.
And he rows every day. So he rows every day at around 6 a.m. and he loves it still.
Hi, my name is Emily Schumacher, and I'm the club manager of the Calgary Rowing Club.
Let's go more in depth of the programs that the Calgary Rowing Club offers, starting with the junior program.
Yeah, so our junior program goes from 10 to about 18 years old. The kids can start brand new. They don't have to have any experience. We have a novice program, and then once the kids graduate from the novice program, they go to the development program, and then they will graduate into the competitive program. You can row between 3 and 6 times per week. Nobody really takes attendance, so you come as often as you want. And obviously with rowing as well, we're very aware that multi-sport lifestyle is very important for kids, especially that are growing. So there's a lot of kids that are in other sports as well and then use rowing as a complementary sport. And then eventually they might think that this is the sport that they want to keep doing, and then they focus on that a little bit more. So there's a lot of flexibility in there. The kids can race, which is great, or they can also just be on the reservoir and have fun. They don't have to be competitive if they don't want to.
Now, we've talked a lot about the different programs that are offered for kids and youth.
Mm-hmm.
Let's talk about the adult programs, especially the Learn to Row program.
For sure. So our Learn to Row program is for anybody that is an adult and that would like to give your rowing a try. I'd say the average age would be probably from 30 to like 60 plus. Learn to Row individuals would come down to the club, and then over 8 hours usually they will try rowing. So they first go on the indoor rower, which is also called the ERG. Then they will go in our water tank, which is a great place to just practice the movements and the skills without the tippiness of the boat and without having the, I would say, fear of falling into the water. And then we take them out on the water and do all the basic drills, usually with an instructor in the boat, so that everybody can feel comfortable and learn at their own pace. Once they're done with the Learn to Row program, they're welcome to join our rec program, which trains 3 times a week. And so in the rec program, that is pretty much just building skills and then seeing wherever people want to go. Some people want to stay in rec or in the technical development program for their whole life, and some people want to eventually go to racing, so they'll be focusing towards that. So there's something for everybody.
What's the program for adults that want to be competitive called?
So we have two different kinds. We have the senior program, which would be 18 to 27 usually. So that is, I would say, one of the most competitive programs at the Calgary Rowing Club. They usually train in the very early mornings, so you'll see them in the summertime at 5 a.m. getting ready to row. Nobody else wakes up this early. And then we have our master's program, which is for anybody who wants to take it a little bit more leisurely, and but at the same time be competitive. So the master's program usually races only 1 kilometer versus everybody else racing 2 kilometers.
It's cool to see all the different programs that the Calgary Rowing Club offers. And it's not just for training and racing, but also for like corporate and team building opportunities as well.
Absolutely. So if there's anybody that wants to come down and have a team building experience, we have an opportunity to do so. We also have, and I don't want to forget that, we have a great para program at the CRC as well. So we have, I believe it's 3 or 4 shells that can be made into para rowing boats. And so we can do arms only, arms and trunks, and in full body rowing for, I think it's called PR1, PR2, PR3. So we have that available here as well, which is great. So we can offer rowing to anybody that really wants to row.
What are some other misconceptions that the Calgary Rowing Club is always trying to break?
Probably that rowing doesn't even exist in Calgary. So lots of people don't know that rowing is here. When I first moved here in 2015, and I told people that I just met on the street that I was going to be in Calgary working at the Calgary Rowing Club, they're like, this, where do you row? Like, they didn't even know that this was something on the Glenmore Reservoir that you could do. So it's always astounding that it's such a beautiful place to be outside and like use as a Calgarian, and most people don't really know about it.
One misconception that I've actually read as well is that a lot of people say, oh, it's a sport for older people. It's not a sport that's for kids.
Oh, it's definitely a sport for kids, absolutely. There are different, so it'd be hard for us to have a 6-year-old join us at this point in time because the equipment just won't fit them. We do try to make sure that we have the right safe and sized equipment for all the kids. So usually we can take kids 10 years to 18 and start them from there.
If you wanted to say one thing to Calgarians to get them into the sport of rowing with the Calgary Rowing Club, what would you say to them?
If you'd like to participate in a sport in a great community, in a beautiful setting with a lot of like-minded people that want to work hard but also want to have fun together, then I would definitely say rowing, you should give rowing a try.
And if you would like to learn more about this sport or any other activity, just check out Sport Calgary's website at sportcalgary.ca.